Hello everybody and welcome to the Creatrix YouTube channel. I welcome you all in a fresh session of analog electronics. And my dear friends, when I say we are going to learn analog electronics from the very basic, I mean it. We will be learning from the very, very basic level to the very advanced level along with a lots and lots of questions. So before we do that, let me first introduce myself for my friend who is meeting me for the first time. My dear friends, my name is Ankit Goyal. I got AIR1 twice in GATE in 2014 and 2018. I was awarded the President of India Gold Medal in the year 2013 when I graduated from IIT Indore. Till date, I have trained more than 1 lakh students in the online and the offline classes and presently working as a director at an academy for GATE department. But my dear friends, the reason behind this series is because of the huge demand of analog electronics. And the belief that whenever you ask for anything, we are there to deliver. Yes, my dear friends, we are here for you. We are here delivering for you. And when we say it, we'll support you to the very, very fullest level. And this series will help you crack GATE with the top rank. It will enable EC student to get 12 out of 12 and 5 out of 5 for electrical students. So my dear friends, if you want to learn with us live, then you can join an academy using the code ANKITASE to get an immediate 10% discount. And not only my dear friend 10% discount, it also brings you under my guidance so that I can help you do something that I have done. I can at least take you near to this goal. Okay, so if you also dream the same thing, then join me in this journey on an academy subscription using the code ANKITASE. Now, my dear friend, if you like the content that I deliver, you can watch more of my free videos on this URL, tinyurl.com/ankitase. Here you will find all my videos arranged subject-wise, chapter-wise, and you will find great content for free. And you are definitely going to love it. You are definitely going to enjoy. It not only includes conceptual videos, but it also includes problem-solving sessions. So just visit this once and you will fall in love with this URL. Don't forget it. It is a lifeline for you. And if you love the content that we are delivering on YouTube, we have created the first ever video book for you guys, where you will find all the videos along with all the notes that we provide arranged subject-wise, chapter-wise. So now, my dear friends, your dreams are no longer dreams. They are becoming a reality because you are getting a top quality course, well arranged, well structured, and that too for free. So what can be better than that? Nothing, my dear friends. So we have empowered the dreams of those who earlier used to think that only the person with a huge amount of money can crack GATE with a top rank. No, my dear friends, that is not the case. Even you can do it. But yes, just you need to believe in yourself and visit this link. But remember, this is a case sensitive link, so write this in uppercase. Other than that, if you join plus subscription, you get all the top educators like me teaching you live in daily lectures, along with providing you daily practice paper, weekly quiz, test series, previous year question, practice question, crash course, rank improvement batch, and most importantly, clearing your each and every doubt. So if you join plus subscription, it is an entire world inside it. So you don't have to look outside. Once you enter plus, every need of yours will be taken care of and we will make your journey as smooth as possible towards that destination of getting under 100, under 10 rank. Believe me, my friend, you leave that strategy part to us. You leave the content part to us. You just work hard and we will make sure that you obtain the top rank in GATE and ESE. And Iconic is a big brother of Plus. Yes, this is a little brother. So Iconic gives you everything that the Plus subscription gives, along with much more. The major part of Iconic is this personal coach, a person dedicated to you on a daily basis to get you the top rank, guiding you, getting your schedule designed, making your strategy. Everything that you need to get the top rank is being done by this personal coach. He'll also create a study planner for you, which you can follow blindly and reach your destination with utmost ease. They will be analyzing your test result and tell you where you are lacking, how you can improve. So that way, my dear friend, everybody else will get a standard analysis, but you will get an analysis just tailor-made for you. Along with it, we have included study material additionally, theory and question bank, and soon we'll be introducing interview guidance into this. So this will become a complete package for a student who wants to take that journey from being an average student to sitting into a PSU or a M.Tech seat. So for them, this journey will be just like driving a Lamborghini to work. So that sort of a experience, that sort of a royal experience we are going to give you. So let's move on to the lecture. And if you want to join an academy, just make sure you use the code ANKITESE to get my guidance as well as to get 10% over and above whatever an academy offers you. So now let's move on to the lecture, dear friends, and let's see what we have in store for you.
Hi guys, in this video we'll be starting a new topic which is called as the feedback amplifier. Now what is meant by feedback amplifier actually? It is an amplifier in a closed loop configuration. Closed loop means that the output signal is also fed back to the input terminal. That is, a portion of output signal is again connected back to the input signal, and that is called as a feedback amplifier. On your screen, you can see the block diagram of a feedback amplifier. What all components do we have? First, we have a source of the signal. This is the signal that you want to amplify. Okay, it is the input signal. Then we have comparator or mixer network. Just like control system in closed loop system, we have a summing element which we also call as comparator. So that comparator here is also called as mixer network. Why mixer network? Because it is mixing the two signal, the input signal and the feedback signal. Okay. So here we have shown the feedback voltage and the feedback current. The net signal is called as the input signal. Okay, so the signal going from the source terminal is called as the source signal, and the signal obtained after mixing of source and the feedback is called as input signal. Okay, now this input signal is input to the amplifier. The amplifier has a voltage gain A. Okay, it might be voltage gain, current gain, depending upon the nature of amplifier. As I have told you earlier also, there are four kind of amplifier: voltage amplifier, current amplifier, transconductance amplifier and the transresistance amplifier. So here the amplifier has a gain of A. Then we have a sampling network. What is the purpose of this sampling network? Is to take out the output signal in order to feed it back to the input signal. Like in control system, what we say is, this is G, this is H, and we show like this. This we call as takeoff point. Okay. This takeoff point basically here is shown as a sampling network. So what is the purpose of sampling network? The purpose of sampling network is to take the output signal and send it back to the input signal. So sampling network samples the output signal in order to use it as a feedback. Then this signal output from the sampling network passes through the feedback network. Feedback network also has a gain of beta. Okay, so feedback gain is beta. What is the meaning of feedback gain? Suppose the voltage here is V0 and the voltage feedback is beta. So Vf by V0 is beta, like this. If current is fed back and we are taking current as the output, it is also beta. It depends on situation to situation what is the feedback signal and what is the output signal. Like the output can be voltage or current. Same way the feedback can also be voltage and current. Based on this we can have how many combination? 4. Feedback voltage, output voltage. Feedback current, output current. Feedback current, output voltage. Feedback voltage, output current. That way we can have 4 possible combination, which I have told Vf V naught, Vf, I naught, If, V naught, and If, I naught. And these will correspond to the four type of amplifier that I have already taught you: transresistance, transconductance, voltage, and the current amplifier. Okay. So basically, the relation between the output and the feedback signal is given by the feedback gain, that is beta. Okay. Beta is the feedback gain. Is it fine? Now, basically, in this topic, we'll be discussing more upon two things. One is the comparator or the mixer network, and the second one is the sampling network. These two things are very important to us, and we'll understand how to identify the feedback configuration based on sampling and the mixing network. Now, first of all, if we talk about the sampling circuit. So, sampling circuit, basically what it does is, it takes the output signal. And I have told, when we talk about output signal, what are the possibilities in case of output signal? Basically, there are two possibilities, V naught and I naught. So, if V naught is fed back, that means you are taking the output voltage, then it is called as voltage sampling. That is, you are taking the sample of the output voltage. If I naught is fed back, that means you are taking the sample of current, then it is called as the current sampling. Okay. So, there are two types of sampling, either voltage sampling or the current sampling. Now, see, when we want to take the voltage, then this feedback wires are connected parallel to this RL. Okay, are you seeing this? This wire is connected parallel to RL, which means we are directly taking V naught, and V naught is going into the feedback network. This beta is nothing but the feedback network. A is the forward path gain. So, that is the representation of voltage sampling. And since you are taking parallel connection of the feedback network, the resistance will reduce in parallel. So, output resistance with feedback is less than the output resistance without feedback. What is R0F? It is output resistance with feedback. R naught is output resistance without feedback. Since we are taking parallel connection of the feedback network, in parallel connection the resistance decreases, hence output resistance with feedback is less than the output resistance without feedback. See the second circuit. In the second circuit, if you see, in the feedback network, we are not taking V naught, but we are taking I naught. That is why this wire is not connected parallel to RL, but it is connected in series like this. So, the feedback network is connected in series with RL, or it will be called as the current sampling, because the feedback network input is your load current or output current R naught. Since you have connected in series the effective resistance increases. So, R0F is greater than R0. Okay. So, if you are taking connection in parallel, the resistance will reduce. If you are taking connection in series, the resistance will increase. Okay. In parallel, what we are sampling? We are sampling the voltage. In series, we are sampling the current. So, based on connection of the feedback network, we can tell whether it is current sampling or the voltage sampling. Okay. So, there are two types of sampling. Next, we talk about the mixer network. What is this mixer network? It basically combines, the source signal with feedback signal. okay? So mixer network always combines the source signal with the feedback signal. That is why it is called as the mixer, because it is mixing the two signal. Now again, when you are adding or subtracting two signals, there are two possibilities. What are the two possibilities? Either you are adding or subtracting the voltages, or you are adding or subtracting the current. Okay. Don't think of it as four combination, because I am also talking about addition and subtraction. So effectively there are four combination, but that will be taken care in positive and negative feedback. That is, when we are adding the two signal, it is positive feedback. When we are subtracting the two signal, then it is negative feedback. Okay. So what I mean to say is, when you are mixing the two signal, either both signals are voltages or both the signals are current. So there are two possibilities. One is called as voltage mixing, and the other is called as the current mixing. The first block diagram shows voltage mixing. How? I told you the input to the amplifier is called as the input signal. This is your input signal. And the source connected is called as the source signal. And the output of the feedback network is called as the feedback signal. So once you combine the source and the feedback signal, then we get the input signal. Now let us apply KVL like this. So what I'll say, Vs minus Vi minus Vf equal to 0. So Vi is Vs minus Vf. So if you see, the source and the feedback voltages are subtracted to give me the input voltage. So I am saying it is voltage mixing. Now if you see, when voltages are added or subtracted, then it is your series connection. In series connection, resistance increases or decreases? Resistance increases. If resistance increases, RIF is greater than RI. What is RIF? It is input resistance with feedback. What is RI? Input resistance without feedback. Okay. See the second case. Here II is the input current, IS is the source current, and IF is the feedback current. Now apply KCL. This is IS, this is II. So I'll say IS minus IF is II. Again, to obtain the input current, we are subtracting the source and the feedback current. That is why it will be called as your current mixing. But if you see, this is an example of parallel configuration, because currents are added or subtracted only in parallel, not in series. In parallel, what happens? The resistance reduces. So that is why RIF is actually less than RI. Okay. And whenever the source and the feedback signal are subtracted, it will be termed as the negative feedback. What is the meaning of negative feedback? That the feedback signal is reducing the effective value of the input signal by getting subtracted from the source. See, if there was no feedback, the input signal will be same as the source signal. But due to feedback signal, the input signal is reduced, and that is basically called as the negative feedback. Okay. So we will see why do we go for negative feedback later on. But just remember, when the source and the feedback signal are subtracted, then it is termed as the negative feedback. Next, let us talk about the closed loop gain of an feedback amplifier. Now there are two possibilities in feedback, either a minus sign or a plus sign. Minus sign means negative feedback. So first let us talk about negative feedback. This is the feedback signal XF. It is feedback gain multiplied by the output signal X naught. Then what is the input signal? I told you input signal is combined effort of the source signal and feedback. But we are taking minus sign only. So XS minus XF. Okay. Or XS minus beta X naught. Now this XI is getting as an input to the amplifier. So you can say output of the amplifier is gain multiplied by input, that is A XS minus beta X naught, that is A XS minus A beta X naught. So if you take both the terms on the left hand side, X naught into 1 plus A beta is equal to A XS. So X naught over XS is A over 1 plus A beta. Now in case if there is no feedback, if there is no feedback, you can say beta equal to 0. In that case the gain would be equal to A. This is called as your open loop gain. This you can compare with the control system. There the open loop transfer function is represented by G. Here we are representing it by A. And this function is called as closed loop gain. So you can say that the gain with feedback is open loop gain by 1 plus A beta. Okay. So this will be less than A. This value will come out to be less than A. That means by the use of negative feedback, the gain reduces. Okay. So we are using negative feedback, and in that feedback, the gain is being reduced. So if you want to represent the feedback, the effect of feedback in decibel, then you will write 20 log on the base of 10. Gain with feedback over gain without feedback. So how much will it come out to be? 20 log 10, 1 over 1 plus A beta. So that is the effect of feedback in decibel. But always remember, by the use of negative feedback, the gain reduces. Now suppose I take the other possibility, that is with a positive sign. We know that XF was beta X naught. But when we talk about input signal, instead of subtracting the source and feedback signal, the signals will be added. So it will become XS plus beta X naught. Now this XI is input to the amplifier. So X naught will be A XI. So it is A into XS plus beta X naught, or you can say A XS plus A beta X naught. So you will write X naught into 1 minus A beta is equal to A XS, which means X naught by XS is A over 1 minus A beta. Again without feedback. Without feedback, what is the gain? The gain is equal to A. But with feedback, the gain is A over 1 minus A beta. So if you see the denominator, the term in the denominator is actually less than 1. So this value will come out to be greater than A. Because the denominator is less than 1, the overall value will be greater than A. So it means that In positive feedback, the gain of the amplifier increases. In negative feedback, the gain reduces. In positive feedback, the gain increases. So if I want to find the effect of feedback in decibel, as I told earlier, it will be 20 log on the base of 10 mod of gain with feedback upon without feedback. So 20 log on the base of 10, 1 over 1 minus A beta. Okay, that is called as your effect of feedback in decibel. Is it fine? So just remember one thing, in negative feedback the gain reduces, in positive feedback the gain increases. Okay, that much you have to remember for now. Now let us talk about another term, that is gain sensitivity. Now gain sensitivity represents how much does the gain of feedback amplifier is stable or it remains constant with respect to the external changes. So gain sensitivity represents how much stable is the gain of closed loop amplifier or feedback amplifier with respect to external changes. That is, even if we change small factors like temperature, pressure, humidity, all these factors should not affect the gain of the closed loop amplifier, and that is called as your sensitivity. Okay, so we know that the gain with feedback is, in negative feedback, it is A over 1 plus A beta. So why I am taking negative feedback? Because negative feedback is used in amplifier, whereas positive feedback is used in oscillator. And right now I am only talking about amplifier, so I am taking negative feedback. Now if you differentiate this feedback gain with respect to open loop gain, so we will apply quotient rule. Derivative of numerator is 1 multiplied by denominator minus derivative of denominator is beta multiplied by numerator whole divided by denominator square. So it is 1 over 1 plus A beta whole square. Okay. Now when we talk about sensitivity, we write it like this: fractional change in closed loop gain divided by fractional change in open loop gain. The same thing you will study in control systems also when we talk about sensitivity of a control system. So we are taking fractional change and not the absolute change. So it is A by AF into DAF by DA. A is A, AF is A over 1 plus A beta into DAF by DA is 1 over 1 plus A beta square. So this sensitivity is 1 by 1 plus A beta, which is less than 1. It means that fractional change in closed loop gain is less than fractional change in open loop gain. And if you multiply by 100, fractional change can be converted to your percentage change. So percentage change in closed loop gain is less than percentage change in open loop gain. So it is a beneficial thing for us. Why beneficial? Because even if the open loop gain changes due to environmental effect, the closed loop gain will change by small amount or it will remain almost constant. Okay, that is what we desire, that the closed loop gain should not change with respect to environment even if the open loop gain changes. Now we define another term which is called as desensitivity. Desensitivity is 1 over sensitivity it is 1 plus A beta. Okay, just remember this term desensitivity, it is reciprocal or reverse of your sensitivity. Okay, so what is the purpose of defining sensitivity? We want to know how will the closed loop gain of the amplifier will change if open loop gain changes due to certain factor. To study that, we are defining the term sensitivity. Now let us understand why we go for negative feedback when we know that negative feedback reduces the gain. Okay, we know that thing. So then why we are going for negative feedback? Okay, so the first reason is frequency distortion. What is this frequency distortion actually? When we were studying BJT, I told you when we were studying frequency response that there are capacitances involved in the amplifier, due to which we saw that the frequency response was somewhat like this. Like this. Okay. Which means the gain was varying with frequency at low frequencies and high frequency. The gain was varying with the frequency. That means there will be frequency distortion, or the amplification will depend on frequency. Why I am saying distortion? Suppose there is a signal which contains multiple frequencies means multiple sinusoidal signal with different frequency. Suppose there is a square wave. A square wave can be expressed as Fourier series. So it will have multiple harmonics or multiple frequencies. Now since gain is a function of frequency, each frequency or each component will have different gain. If they all have different gain, the shape of the output signal will not be identical to the input signal, and that is called as the distortion or frequency distortion. If all components do not have the same gain, the shape of the output signal cannot be identical to the input signal. Okay, so by the use of negative feedback, this frequency distortion is reduce. So that is the first reason why we are going for negative feedback. Then the second is non-linear distortion. It means if your network contains certain non-linear element like diodes and the BJTs, then due to non-linearity of such element, the shape of the signal will change, and that is called as non-linear distortion. So non-linear distortion with feedback is equal to non-linear distortion by 1 plus A beta. So it is also reduced. What is non-linear distortion? The change in the shape of the signal due to non-linear nature of the devices used in the network is called as non-linear distortion. The third factor is noise. Noise is nothing but a high frequency unwanted signal that is introduced in the system either externally or internally. Okay, due to environment or any other external components also, the noise can be induced in the system. So that noise also is reduced due to feedback. So it is open loop noise by 1 plus A beta. Okay, that means the noise in the output signal will be reduced if you are using a feedback amplifier rather than the open loop amplifier. Okay, and the last factor is your bandwidth. I told you what is the bandwidth. Bandwidth is nothing but the range of frequencies over which the gain almost remains same is called as bandwidth. Okay, I have told you in negative feedback the gain is reducing, but we know one thing, that the product of gain and bandwidth always remains constant. So suppose earlier the gain was high like this, then what was the bandwidth? This was the bandwidth. Now the gain has reduced. So what should happen to the bandwidth? The bandwidth should ideally increase. If the gain reduces, the bandwidth should increase. Okay, this is the new bandwidth, this is the old bandwidth. So gain multiplied by bandwidth should be constant, since gain in feedback is less than gain in open loop. The bandwidth in feedback is greater than the bandwidth in open loop. Okay, so by reducing the gain in negative feedback, we are increasing the bandwidth. Okay, so if we summarize the effect of negative feedback, all type of distortion decreases, noise decreases, and bandwidth increases. The gain also reduces. Okay, so that is why we use the negative feedback. So if I summarize what I have covered in this video, I have told you about the basic of the feedback amplifier, why we are using feedback amplifier and what is the block diagram, and then we have seen the two important components of a feedback amplifier, that is the sampling network and the mixer network. In both, I have told you there are two possibilities, voltage, current, voltage, current. And then I have told you based on these two choices, there are four possible combinations, each corresponding to one type of amplifier. Then we saw the gain in the closed loop configuration is A over 1 plus A beta for negative feedback and A over 1 minus A beta for the case of positive feedback. Okay. Then we saw sensitivity for negative feedback. It was 1 by 1 plus A beta square. And it represented the percentage change or the fractional change in closed loop gain with respect to fractional change in open loop gain. And D sensitivity was 1 by S. And then I have told you the effect of negative feedback, that it reduces noise and distortion and increases the bandwidth. Okay. So in the next video, we'll cover different type of feedback configuration. As I have told you, there are four possible combinations. So we'll cover each and every combination, but we'll start in the next lecture. Thank you.
I hope all of you have enjoyed the lecture that we were providing and all of you learned something very, very good. Now is the time to learn about the Unacademy subscription. So as I told the benefits of the Plus subscription at the very beginning, let's go through them very, very quickly. Live classes you get by the top educators, crash course, rank improvement badge, doubt clearing, weekly quiz, test series, previous year question, practice question, everything in one subscription called as Unacademy Plus. And iconic is one level higher. It provides you a personal coach who will mentor you on a daily basis, who will guide you on a daily basis, along with providing you study planner, test analysis, study material, and soon enough, interview guidance. So if you are looking to join Unacademy, let's see what are the pricing. So my dear friends, before we see the pricing, just see the link. This link will help you crack GATE and ESE with the top rank, because we have created the first ever video book for GATE and ESE for my YouTube family, and you will get the notes as well as the lectures here. Just make sure that you write this link in the uppercase and you will get to the first ever video book for GATE and ESE, and it is nothing but revolutionary. Now let's see the pricing of Plus subscription. So for 12 months, the pricing is 3250, but if you apply the code Ankit ESE, it becomes 27225. For 18 months, it will be 34650, and for 24 months, 39600. Believe me, my dear friend, this is the most affordable pricing, and the longer duration subscriptions are more cost effective as compared to shorter duration. Like here, it will cost you 1650 per month. Okay, this will be 2000 per month approx. This will be around 2250 per month. Then if you go for Iconic for 12 months, it is 5250 with code Ankit ESE, it becomes 45225. And 2 year subscription becomes 66600. So the choice is your, but take a longer duration subscription for more cost effective solution and to give GATE and ESE at least 2 times, so that if you once crack GATE, in the next attempt you can even get ESE. And other than that, my friends, you can download the Unacademy Learning app right now, because there we provide live classes for free, test series and live quizzes for free. And once you download it, make sure that you follow this profile. This is my profile, so that whenever I come live, you will get the notification. And this is the Telegram channel for our team. Here you will find all the lecture links, all the lecture files, and all the links for the special classes. Other than that, my friend, my personal Telegram channel also you can join, t.me/gateair1. Here you can get in touch with me and we can take this journey together. Okay. Other than that, we have other YouTube channels like Mechanical, Civil and Telugu, JE channel, Computer Science, Gate Question and Electrical Junction, Paathshala and GS Terminal. Electrical Junction contains short videos of great concepts. Paathshala provides you animated content. JE preparation can be done through these two channels, Unacademy SSC JE and GS Terminal. And you can refer the other channels to the other friends in respective branches, so that they can also be benefited. At last, I would like to say, please share, like and subscribe to this channel. Subscribe to this channel, and not only subscribe, press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever a new video comes. And share this videos among all your college group, among all your friends, so that we can create the first ever revolution of free education in field of GATE and ESE. Thank you to everybody for dedicating time to watching this video. Please move on to the next one as well, and take the benefit of all the free content that we are providing. And in case you have completed the series, do make sure you watch the other subjects available on this channel. Thank you.